Assalamu alaikum students, your instructor Abdul Rafi here for A-level mathematics. We are discussing the chapter of Poisson distribution, and now we are going to discuss the concept number 4. That is basically how do you find out the unknowns, okay? So let's say you have to find the value of x, or you have to find the value of the lambda, okay? So these type of questions can come in a very different manner as well. So as we are doing 2019 May, June, October, November, all variance topical past papers. So we are going to look at every aspect of this chapter. So find the values of lambda or the n or unknowns, okay? You can write the values. How do you find out the values of the unknowns? So this is concept number 4, and I'm going to do 2 examples on this. So here we go. It says that the random variable, it's a 2-mark question only. The random variable y has the distribution Poisson. So you are going to say that y follows a Poisson distribution, that is lambda. And then you have the, so y follows Poisson distribution lambda, and they are saying when y is 0, the probability of y is 0 is equals to probability of y is equals to 2, and you have to find the value of lambda. So very simple, just have to equate them both together. So let's do this. So it will be e power minus lambda. We don't know what is the value of lambda, right students? But we know that it will be e power minus lambda, and it will be multiplied with lambda power 0 divided by 0 factorial is equals to equivalent to e power minus lambda multiply by lambda power square divided by 2 factorial, okay? So just have to put them together. You just have to do it the basic normal way, just the way you write the Poisson distribution. So y is equals to 0 and y is equals to 2. So it is going to be very simple. You are going to say that, sir, you can cancel out the lambda and the lambda, right? First thing will be e power minus lambda, and this e power minus lambda will be cancelled out, okay? Because you can, they are both multiplying here, so you can take it there to and divide there. They both will cancel out, students. Next, you need to understand that, sir, anything to the power of 0 is always 1. So this thing, because 0 factorial and lambda power 0 is going to come as 1. And here we go. We have 1 is equals to lambda square is 2 factorial. Everyone knows what is 2 factorial. 2 factorial is 2 times 1, students. So that's going to 2. So here we go. 2 is equals to lambda square. And you're going to say that, sir, definitely lambda cannot be negative. Okay, students, so you're only going to have a positive lambda. Positive mean, so lambda value is going to be square root 2, okay? Understand that we never take the lambda value as negative, okay? This is the rule of this chapter. We are not going to deal with any, we are, because you understand number of cars in an accident, number of phone calls made, number of animals seen, okay? So they can never be negative, okay? So that is why this is the correct answer, students, for this concept number 4. Hope everyone got this, that this is just basically simple solving. No better explanation needed for this. Just need to understand that you can be asked some tricky questions, difficult questions that we are going to also practice further. Understand the important, student, that this is general type of questions that can be asked on the finding the value of lambda and the unknowns, okay? We are going to discuss more questions as well. Let's look at another question as well that I figured out in 2019 papers, was exactly similar type, that the random variable y has the distribution Poisson, that is lambda. Given that probability of y, this time this is for 3 marks now, okay? So eventually the question will be of 2 to 3 marks. So they are saying that probability of y is equals to 3 is equivalent to, is equals to probability of y is equals to 5. So here we go. Y follows the Poisson distribution, that is lambda. And here we go. We are going to write this down, that probability of y is equals to 3 is equivalent to probability of y is equals to 5, sir. And let's get working on this. It will be e power minus lambda again. And this time it will be lambda power 3 divided by 3 factorial. And this will be equals to e power minus lambda multiplied by lambda power 5 divided by 5 factorial as well, students. Okay. Make sure if you make the equation correct, students, then there will be no problem at all, okay? If you make the equations correct. So here you go, e power minus lambda will cancel out with, sir, e power minus lambda. It will cancel out, students, e power minus lambda and lambda. And now you can just simplify. So you're going to say that there is this lambda power 3 divided by 3 factorial and lambda power 5 divided by 5 factorial. So you can work out the values that, sir, 3 lambda, 3 factorial is basically 3 into 2 into 1. So that is basically 6, and 5 factorial is basically 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So that will be basically 5 fours are 20, 23s are 60, 62s are 120 according to me. Okay, so we can write down that it will be lambda 3 is equal divided by 6. Just to simplify further, lambda 5 is equals to divide by 120. And now you cross multiply and take it everything to one side, okay? So lambda can cancel out because their powers are more. So you can say that lambda 5 divided by lambda 3, this lambda will come here, lambda power 3, and that will go there, 120 divided by 6. So here we go, students, we are going to get lambda square is equals to 120 divided by 6, that will be 20, okay? So here we go, lambda square is 20. And now, as I mentioned, that lambda will only take positive values, okay? So here we go, square root 20 you can write, or you can simplify by saying that this can be 2 square root 5. Better to write in the search form or in the exact form, not to give it the answer in decimals. Or if you want to give the answer in decimals, give it to one decimal place as well, okay, if they are mentioning. But this is the answer. So hope everyone got this example, two examples. How do you find the lambda in this type of question when you have concept number 4, finding the unknowns? One answer we got square root 20, and the other answer we got was square root 2, basically on our concept number 4, finding the value of lambda or n unknown, okay? Thank you, students. Assalamu alaikum, students. Moving forward, let's discuss other type of examples on the concept number 4 of finding the unknowns, okay? So in previous example, we discussed the finding of how to find lambda in different situations, okay? Now we are going to discuss how to find the x values, okay, in different situations, okay? So let's work it out. We'll have to take help from the original question. So it says that the random variable x has the Poisson distribution 5, which means that x follows the lambda value is 5, okay, students? And they are saying that probability of x is equals to n. Follow carefully, this is not tricky, but students find this difficult, is equals to probability of x is equals to n plus 1. Students need to understand very carefully what they are trying to just say is basically whatever your value of n is, the other one is n plus 1. One more, it's the next consecutive number. So let's take an example. Let's say if the value of, just giving you an example, students, if the value of n is 10, which means n plus 1 will be 11, right? Because if that value is 10 here, so it will be 10 plus 1, 11. So it's just the consecutive words that they are looking for, okay? Consecutive numbers will be there. So follow very carefully how we are going to solve this. You are going to say that first thing is basically part 2, that you have to write down an equation in n for 1 mark, and then for 1 mark, hence or otherwise, you have to find the value of n, okay? Hence or otherwise, you have to find the value of n. So here we go. It is going to be simple, that is e power minus lambda, okay, multiply by 5 power the n value divided by n factorial, okay? So this is one equation, okay, students? Hope everyone gets this. E power minus 5 multiplied by 5 power n divided by n lambda, okay, is equivalent to e power minus 5. And you're going to, this time, the lambda value is 5 and power will be n plus 1 divided by, sir, n plus 1 factorial, okay? Very important to understand the common understanding here, n plus 1 factorial, okay? So students need to understand that there is n factorial, there are n plus 1 factorial. As the common in the previous examples, we have discussed that e power minus 5 and e power minus 5 will cancel out because they are just dividing each other. So you can just use any variable here and cancel this out, okay, students? So this is your equation, this is your part 1 marks, okay? So if you leave it as it is, just like 5 power n divided by n factorial, and you leave the other one, that is 5 power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 factorial, you are going to get all the marks. Okay, students. Now, how you are going to solve this? So in order to solve this, students need to understand very carefully some logic concepts as well. This is 5 power n divided by n factorial, right? And the next one is equals to 5 power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 whole factorial. So because this is equals to, you can cross multiply and change their places. So I'm going to do that first. Students, follow carefully. N plus 1 factorial divided by n factorial will come here, and 5 power n plus 1 divided by 5 power n will come here. Now follow the example. Always remember this type of question, students, you follow my example, okay? How do solving technique I'm giving you. Understand the importance that this will make you confused. If you think directly, think like this way. Think by taking an example. Let's say that, sir, n value was 7. So if n value was 7, okay, let's imagine that n value was 7. It means in the numerator, it was 8 factorial, and in the denominator, it was 7 factorial. Here also, sir, it will was 5 power 8 here and 5 power 7 here. Okay, students, n plus 1 is 8 and n is 7. We are taking an example, n is 7. So understand, students, if you look carefully on the right hand side, it is 5 power 8 divided by 5 power 7. It means that this is n and this is 1 more than that. So if you simplify and if you solve this, okay, you are going to be left with 1 power of f, right? If you solve this, okay, only the right hand side, okay, if you follow in the highlighter, students, a lot of students gets worried about this part, okay? If you only solve the right hand side, you will always get the answer as 5, okay? Hope everyone is getting it. You change the example, take the n value as 15, take the n value as 100, take any n value, an integer number, 99, 97, 75, 63, 64, you will get the answer as 5 only, because it's all the 5 power of 7 will cancel out with all the 5 power of 7 and you will be only left with 1 power of 5, okay? So if students get this concept, okay, you need to understand that on the right hand side, you're only going to get 5, okay? Hope everyone got this, that on the right hand side, you're only going to get the 5 power 1, okay, because everything will cancel out. And let's just remove this example now. So 5 power n and 5 power, that thing will cancel out, okay. If this is 7, this is 8, so you're only going to left with 1 power of that. So 5 power 1 is 5. And let's talk about the left hand side now. If you're going to talk about the left hand side, what is 8 factorial? 8 factorial is something like, if you have done the P1 binomial carefully, it is exactly this thing, okay? So you cancel out that, it will be n plus 1 left, okay? You can write down 8 into 7 factorial, or you can write like this, 7 into 6 into 5. These all will cancel out, students, except only 8 will be left. And what is 8? 8 is just n plus 1, okay? If you see, 8 is just n plus 1, right? N is 7 and 8 is n plus 1. So understand this carefully and you will get the direct answer that if n plus 1 factorial is divided by n factorial, it is going to come as n plus 1 only, okay, students? It's going to come as n plus 1 only. Hope everyone got the example. Do it through an example. You are going to be left with n plus 1 factorial divided by n factorial. You will be only left with n plus 1. And on the right hand side, you will be only left with the Poisson distribution lambda. Okay. So here we go. It becomes easy to solve. So n value is going to come as 4 here, students. Okay. Hope everyone got this concept that n value is going to come as 4 here, students. And this is how you are going to solve this whole question. Hope everyone got this. The answer matches the marking scheme as well. Make sure you understand the most important concept is basically how do you deal with the n plus 1 and the n, okay? And similarly, n plus 1 factorial divided by n factorial is going to leave you with n plus 1 only. Let's look at another example as well. So students will get this better. And the other example that we have is this one. The random variable z, again, this is 2019 papers, okay? And we have the random variable z has the Poisson distribution 5.2. And it is given that this time it's exactly the same question, just the inequality is coming. So don't have to worry about the inequality as well, students, okay? If it is changing, it will change for, if the sign is changing, you can work that out as well, okay? It's not a big issue and not a big concern as well, okay? So let's just read the question and try to solve it. Okay. So we have to write down an inequality in N for part one for 1 mark, exactly the same question, okay, same type of question. It will be e power minus 5.2 into 5.2 power N divided by N factorial less than e power minus 5.2 into 5.2 power N plus 1 divided by N plus 1 factorial. Okay, students, exactly same thing going to come, okay? Oh, it's just the same way. You have to write down inequality. You cancel this part. Power exponential power lambda, e power minus lambda, e power minus lambda will cancel out, students. And your inequality, you will get the 1 mark as it will be 5.2 power n divided by n factorial is less than 5.2 power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 lambda. Okay, there is nothing negative as well, so you can do the same thing here. Do this way, n plus 1 factorial divided by n factorial is less than 5.2 power n plus 1 divided by 5.2 power n. Okay, because there is nothing negative, so the sign will not change, students. Okay, hope everyone gets this part as well. And here you go again, what I said, n plus 1 factorial divided by n factorial. Let me take another example. Let's say n is 15 now, so n plus 1 will be 16, right? So I imagine that this is 16 factorial divided by 15 factorial and 5.2 power 16 divided by 5.2 power 15. So you understand, students, that again the same thing will be left, only the lambda will be left here and only the n plus 1 will be left here. Okay, so here you go, students, just to simplify and quickly clarify this, it's going to be n plus 1 on the left hand side, okay, and factorial finishes off, and 5.2 on the right hand side, okay. And you, when you finish it, it will be 5.2 minus 1, it will be n is less than 4.2, okay. So hence or otherwise, you have to find the largest value of possible of n. Hence or otherwise, what is the largest possible value of n? What's the maximum value? It will be n is equals to 4, sir, because 4.2 is not an integer, so you'll have to find an integer value. So n is the highest possible value is 4. What other answers are possible? 0 is possible, 1 is possible, 2 is possible, 3 is possible. All of these answers are possible, but you need to understand that n value will be 4 because they're asking for the largest possible value of n. Hope everyone got this concept number 4 as well of the Poisson distribution. Thanks.